Hey guys, okay, so I've got Justin here and he's gonna walk us through what it looks like to actually collect lizard aggression behavior data. So how long are your aggression trials?
So my aggression trials are 10 minutes.
Yeah,
that's 10 minutes of just sitting and waiting for behavior to happen.
Do you ever get bored while you're
sitting? A little bit sometimes. So sometimes the lizards just sit there and that's 10 minutes of inactivity. But other times it's 10 minutes of constant behaviors, just back to back to back.
Okay, so there's two lizards in your aggression chamber. Are you watching both lizards simultaneously, or how does that work?
Well, I personally will only focus on one lizard at a time. And then while I'm watching the trial, I want the behaviors from that lizard I'm watching. Now, if I'm going to record the other lizard's behavior, I'll have someone else with me to record that lizard. So that way I'm focused on the behaviors of one lizard at a time.
So you would watch one lizard and I'd watch another lizard.
Cool.
All right, so you have a list of behaviors that you use to actually calculate aggression, right?
Correct.
I'm gonna post this list of behaviors in the video description below. So if you want this list of behaviors, you want to score an aggression trial, you'll just have to pull this list up and print it off. So the first behavior is retreat. What does that look like?
The retreating is whenever a lizard is running away from another lizard doing one of these other behaviors.
Okay, what about tail switch?
So a tail switch is whenever they do this like S-shaped motion, like a snake with their tail.
And approach?
An approach is whenever one lizard walks towards another lizard. A head bob is whenever they do this little up and down motion with their head.
Dude, you got that head bob down.
Oh, I practice.
Throat display.
So throat display, they will inflate their throat. They won't inflate any other part of their body, but they will make their throat look as large as they can to be a little more intimidating.
What's the difference between a throat display and a lateral throat display?
So a lateral throat display is a full body action. So they will flatten out their body to show off their orange bars on their side, and they'll do their throat, and they'll generally be broadside to the other lizard. So circling, a lot of times they're already doing a lateral throat display, and then they're in that position and they're just like circling around the other lizard.
So lateral throat display is if you're just steady, you're in one place, and then circling is another behavior
where they're actually moving around the other lizard. Yeah.
Push up?
Push ups, we all know push ups. Up and down.
Okay, what about superimposition?
Superimposition is when one lizard walks or sits on top of another lizard, but it's only body over body. If they're over a tail, it doesn't count.
Okay.
So fighting is whenever both lizards are being aggressive towards each other and trying or being vicious, and they're battling it out.
Okay, so what's the difference between attack and approach?
So an attack is whenever a lizard charges in with the intent to fight towards another lizard. An approach is just a way of getting closer to help insert dominance and control.
Gotcha.
But one is really quick, it's a charge, and the other one's just a movement towards the other lizard.
Okay, and bite.
And bite, well, that's what it says, it's just a bite.
All right, so those are all the behaviors you're looking for. And what you do is you record the number of behaviors, and then different behaviors have different points. So an attack is worth 3, but an approach is only worth 1 point.
Correct, yeah.
So if you have 2 approaches, that's worth 2 points, but if you have 2 attacks, that'd be worth 6 points.
Exactly.
Cool, then you just add it up and get your behavior score.
Yeah, that's it.
All right, so are you going to watch this video and score it, and we can compare what we get to what you get?
Yeah, let's do it.
All right, so the rest of the aggression trial is right now. All right, if you made it through that video and actually did the scoring, I'm super impressed. The reality is, collecting data just takes a lot of time. This was one video. Justin, I think he's scored over 70 videos at this point, and he's gonna have to do, I think, probably like 70 more. I'll ask him next week. Data collection takes a lot of time. Check out next week's episode to see how your data compares to Justin's data.